Let's take a look at how easy it is to build a simple mixer inside the MRX Designer. Let's start with our inputs. First, we choose our inputs and drag them into the design window. We can then choose faders to control the input level. Rather than dragging four in individually, we can double-click on the component in the list, and this will allow us to add multiple instances by just clicking on the design window. To stop it, press Escape. If I start with an individual fader, I can update this by going to the Properties section here and changing the number of channels like this. Next, I might want to add a high-pass filter and a parametric EQ for each channel like this. Then insert a Dan Dugan auto mixer. I can group these all together using a matrix mixer like so, and then route the matrix signal out via Dante to the XMV amplifier in our project. So I need to locate the Dante output component and place it in my design. To cable these together, I can do it individually like this, or I can grab groups of connectors and join them like this. To delete, simply select and delete. You might have realized that I appear to have forgotten to route four channels into my auto mixer. I did that on purpose to show you another feature. Imagine we're bringing in four other mic channels from an EXI8 input expander. They'll reach the MRX7D via YDIF. So I need to insert a YDIF input. Then I want to include the same fader and EQs for these inputs. Rather than inserting single components all over again, provided they're not already cabled, I can copy multiple components by selecting them all on the screen, and then control dragging and dropping them onto the screen like this. To label my connection, I can open the analog input editor window and double-click the label area to insert the name. Then by right-clicking on the first cabling connector, I can duplicate the port's label left or right through the design. This will save me a lot of time and allows me to clearly see that I've cabled correctly. When everything's complete in your design, you then have to compile it. Think of it like gluing the whole design together. To do that, we click on the Compile button at the top of the screen. Once complete, it will display the system and DSP resource that your design is using, plus the total latency of the processing.